My name is Dr. Cecilia Low Wang. I'm a professor of medicine at the University of Colorado Anschutz Medical Campus School of Medicine. And today I'll be talking about a presentation that is from the ESC 2021 in the late breaking sessions in special populations, looking at the VOYAGER PAD in diabetes patients. VOYAGER PAD was a really interesting study with I think very important findings. And so it's the largest study ever of patients with symptomatic peripheral artery disease immediately after lower extremity revascularization. So it's a total of 6,500 patients or so, and 40% of those patients had diabetes. And so the main question that was addressed in VOYAGER PAD was, how can we treat patients with symptomatic PAD after a revascularization procedure better so that we can improve outcomes? And it was a positive study. So in other words, the use of Rivaroxaban 2.5 milligrams twice daily in addition to low-dose aspirin after lower extremity revascularization in symptomatic PAD was effective in improving outcomes, the primary outcome, which was a composite of limb and cardiovascular outcomes. So the question that the question of the day was, you know, what about the patients with diabetes? Did patients with diabetes who made up 40% of that population experience the same benefit, and what were the risks? And so what was the safety profile and was the efficacy similar? So what we found among the diabetes subgroup analysis, which was pre-specified, is that among the placebo group, which is a way to understand the baseline risk, patients with diabetes and symptomatic PAD after lower extremity revascularization had a very, very high risk of the primary composite outcome. So the risk was about 22% over 3 years, whereas patients without diabetes, that risk was around 18%. So there was about a 4% absolute risk difference. And so that's within the placebo group. Then the second part of this question is, did patients with diabetes experience similar benefits with the primary therapy, which was the Rivaroxaban 2.5 milligrams twice daily, in addition to low-dose aspirin compared to aspirin alone?